It's time to react to Belgium.
Who will make the cut? Who will win our hearts? MJT Reviews.
Hi everyone, it's me, Mitchell James, calling. Oh, where's my badge? Hi everyone, it's me, Mitchell James, calling, and welcome back to MJT Reviews, the channel that your juror probably watches. I bet they do. So, in this video, I am reacting to Belgium. And last year was Hooverphonic representing Belgium. This year, it's Hooverphonic. They're back. Guess who's back? So, I call it Hooverphonic the Rebels of Eurovision because they're kind of doing like songs that, you know, they want to make sure they're doing songs that aren't like typical Eurovision, although I do not know what that means because Eurovision is extremely diverse, but anyway, if you say so. And then everyone from last year did a group song performance of Love Shine a Light except for Hooverphonic. And they were like, we don't like the song. It's like, okay, you were the only one not to do it. But so I call them the Rebels. But one of the guys from Hooverphonic wrote the song Just a Matter of Time by Senek. And I love that song. I absolutely love that song. So I know that they can do amazing things. Release Me was their song last year. And it was actually my least favorite entry of last year. So the only way is up, baby. So let's have a look at the new entry, which is called The Wrong Place. Okay, cool. I'm excited. All right, so what I do is I react to the complete pure audio only. So I'm only listening to audio first, and then I'll look at a music video or preview video. So reacting to just the audio in 1, 2, 3, go. Oh my God, this is so different already. This is already like more poppy. There's a beat. Okay, I feel like they took some criticism. Ooh. Oh, this is much jazzier. Yes. Listen to the harmonies. Yeah. Ooh. This is a lot less stripped and more. Oh, I like the harmonies. So. Yeah, this is the Hooverphonic I'm into. Oh, yeah. Come on. It's still chilled. Whoa, wait. I gotta go back. Oh. No, I really like this. Johnny Cash t-shirt. I'm low-key into this. But I'm already thinking of like, where am I gonna put this in my ranking? But I like the song, you know? Release Me was a grower on me, but like, I mean, this is so like their kind of potential. More like Matter of Time to me. And I feel like we're already getting dynamic, like between the verse and the chorus, verse, bridge, chorus, very kind of structured song compared to the last one. I think kind of had like a chorus as a verse and then like a bridge as like the chorus. And then like it had like three verses or something. Okay, cool. I wonder if they'll do anything like extra at the end. We've got a little bit more to go. You know, I wonder if what the female's range is like. Comment below the name of the female singer. I'm being too lazy to look it up. I'd like to know her range. Maybe it's just too restricted and they have to ride around her range. And then I'm like, I don't fully blame you then. That sounded really high for her. I'm going to leave that for the review, but remind me, I'm going to talk about her range. So interesting. So different. Wow. So let's have a look at the actual music video, if there is one. You're in the wrong place. I love it. Okay, go. That start bit sounds like Almost Home by Mariah Carey, just saying. Yeah, they're very kind of roots, Belgian roots, is that a thing? I'd put them in like folk, this is folk pop. Great, it's got a story, this one. I can't remember what Release Me music video is like. It's good. High quality for it's always funny how there's such like this high budget, or they make it look really high budget on these like indie kind of songs. Oh, was that a swear word? All we did was, yeah, I really can't wait to talk about that rage in my review video coming up. Oh, so much I love. I'm just gonna have to like keep it for that review video. But I could see this even, look, they put this effort into a music video, they're gonna put the effort into the staging. So I'm very interested to see what they do with staging. Remember with Matter of Time by Scenic, whilst they don't have any control over that, when you're a songwriter, you don't have any control. As an artist, you might have a little bit of control. But their staging for that was very minimal. Yeah, I'll keep a bit of what I'm going to say for my review, but I will say that they're, second time I'm listening to it, I'm like, is the hookiness kind of annoying? I don't know. I'm just putting things out. These are like my first impressions. A lot of the time I say these things are my first impressions, and I'm probably going to evolve my opinion the more I hear it to it. Oh, wait. Okay, this is a little bit extra, I swear. You're in the wrong place. It's good, but what I mean, I'm just like, it's kind of brainstorming here, but I don't know if that, I'll keep up on my review, but I was just saying, it's a really kind of fine line when you do like hookiness, and now I'm gonna blame them on, it's too hooky. Not saying that, I think I'm going to need a little bit of time to decide whether that's right. And I'm going to come back to my review video in terms of, can something be too hooky that it becomes kind of like, ugh, you're in the wrong place. Like in a month, am I going to be like, oh, this chorus, which I think I was a little bit like with Release Me. I'm like, release me. Although that grew on me, I must say. At first I was like, ugh. And then I was like, no, I see the little kind of intricacies and everything like that. But okay, I'm going to leave a lot for my review on this one. I'm going to be a little bit more revealing in my reviews as well. So check out my detailed breakdown review on this entry. And feel free to subscribe to see all Eurovision content, where I do more first impression reactions and breakdown review videos. And until next time, bonsoir Europe and goodbye. Who will make the cut? Who will win?